The once considerably Uganda's biggest construction and civil engineering company has been grappling with debts recently. 150,000 shares is what the government of Uganda intends to purchase from Roko Constructions Company Limited at 202 billion shillings in the bid to revamp the company from running insolvent.
Speaker, I beg to lay on the table the proposal for the government of Uganda to acquire 150,000 preference shares worth approximately Uganda shillings 202.13 billion in Roko Construction Limited. I beg to lay.
The Minister of State for Planning, Amos Lugolobi, justified the government's move, saying it's not only saving the company from the financial constraints, but it's also necessary to invest in the construction sector since the country is struggling with housing deficit.
I think it is very important because the name Roko is actually a household name known nearly to everybody in Uganda. Secondly, the construction industry is one of the leading sectors in this country. It's one of those sectors that are driving growth into this country. And as government, we really need to drive the housing sector in terms of providing homes for individuals, but also in terms of providing public.
The matter has, however, attracted mixed reactions from members of parliament who question government's returns from the venture.
Could I request? Is not to get shares in a health company. It is actually a request to help a company that is collapsing. And it has been stated in the request by the minister that they want to help Roko so they can meet their operational costs. They don't want to buy shares, they simply want to help Roko.
Know that Roko has not been a profit-making company for a very long time. We would want to see the justifications for investment in a company such as that, and also given the fact that actually government does not have money, we want to find out what are the priorities of government.
The Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, has referred the proposal to the Committee on Finance for scrutiny and thereafter a report to the House in 1 week.
Today I'm referring this to the Committee of Finance and report back in 1 week. They want to acquire shares.
Item 4.
Why don't you debate when the report comes?
The company, which is running several government contracts, including the construction of parliament chambers, has been struggling to complete them due to financial constraints. This report was compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news.